Hello and welcome to Valley Viewpoint. Fall is here, and with it, fall sports. My guests today are Eric Cantrell, the athletic director for Walla Walla University, and Logan Adams, the sports information director for the same. Gentlemen, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Eric, I understand that you are new to the university, and tell us about your background and about your new position.
Well, thank you for having me. First of all, I'm glad to be here at Walla Walla University. I have a background in athletics, seems like my whole life, and I'm now able to use those skills and the knowledge I've acquired here at Walla Walla University, and I'm happy to be here. I come from Detroit, Michigan. That's my hometown. The last 10 years, I've been the athletic director and head coach at Pine Forge Academy, located in right outside Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I have a Bachelor of Science in Fitness and Wellness from Oakwood University and a Master's in Public Administration and Sports Management from Westchester University in Pennsylvania.
Okay, well, welcome to the university.
Thank you.
As you begin your tenure here, what are some of your goals for the university's athletic program? What's your vision for what athletics is and can be at the university?
When I accepted the position here, I saw a potential of a lot of energy for Walla Walla University's athletics. I think that it has the ability to be the premier Adventist athletic program in the country. And my vision is to make it that, to provide an opportunity for our Adventist kids and others to have a place to go where they will receive a first-class athletic experience through their collegiate career.
Now, in order to help you do that, you've brought somebody else on board here. Logan, give us a little background information for yourself and how things are going here at the university for you.
Yeah, thanks for having me here, Dan. I'm originally from California, grew up there for 25 years, and then moved up to Washington, worked at a boarding school just south of Seattle at Auburn Academy for the past 3 years. I did my undergraduate in Napa Valley at Pacific Union College, and then I got my master's in coaching and athletic administration from Concordia University down in Irvine, Southern California, right before I got the job at Auburn.
Now tell me, what is the role of the sports information director?
So I'm in charge of public relations for all our sports programs. I run the social media, our Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and I write all the press releases and any article that is posted on our athletic website goes through my desk.
Okay, so you're a journalist, you're a sports coordinator. I mean, you have a lot of different skills that are mixed in to the job that you do.
Yeah, another one of my roles is managing our website. So I integrate our social media within our website. And then additionally, I work with game day management. So all our students that we employ, I will be their manager for the upcoming season.
Now, for our viewers, why don't you tell our viewers what the website address is for those who would like to follow the university's athletic program?
It is www.uwolves.com.
Okay, U as in the letter U, not
yep.
the word U.
Yep, the letter U.
Uwolves.com.
Yep.
Okay, very good.
Yep.
Logan forgot he's also in charge of our sponsorships, and he's been out really aggressively pursuing those. It's part of our vision to grow within the community and to have more community involvement with our athletic program here at Walla Walla University.
Well, tell us a little bit more about that, because some of our viewers might be interested in becoming a sponsor.
Yeah, so that's my secondary role, is working with sponsors. And so on our website right now, there's a few packages that we offer. And like Eric mentioned, we're just trying to pinpoint those sponsors that are important in our community and bring them together, because we all want this small community to succeed.
In other words, if one of our viewers is interested in sponsorship, they just need to go to that same Uwolves.
Yep.
And then
there's a navigation tab at the top, under Fan Zone.
Okay.
They'll be able to find more information. And then under our staff directory is all the contact information for myself and Eric. And they're more than willing to we're more than willing to talk and answer any questions.
Okay, so what does this offer to the sponsor if they become involved with the university?
Well, I think one thing is it's when you support Wolves Athletics, it's bringing the community together, and it's you walk into our gym, you see the sponsors that we have, and you know, it's great support for our school, and we love supporting those local businesses.
Okay, so the fans come in, they see this company, that company, they like the fact that they're supporting the university, and it gives them a heads up on a good place to go for whatever, I don't know. Give me some examples of the people.
Yeah, we have Del Taco in there. That's one of our sponsors. Mm-hmm. We have Hayes Electric. We have...
So I know where to get my electrical done. I know where to eat.
Yeah, and we also have Hampton as one of our sponsors. They've been extremely supportive to us, and we have a great relationship with them, and they're awesome to work with.
Okay, very good. Well, how many sports is the university involved with, and what is your connection with the NAIA?
Well, the NAIA is the governing body for the National League that we compete in. And the immediate conference that we're in is the Cascade Collegiate Conference. It's comprised of mostly small Christian-based schools, faith schools in the Northwest region. And we've been a part of that conference for, I believe, about 4 years now. I think Jerry Larson got us in that conference prior to our arrival. But it is a really good competitive conference. We met with the commissioner last week, Rob Cashel. He's a really great guy. He's helped guide us in our first couple of weeks here. And we're really excited to be participating in the Cascade Conference.
Now, this is different from something that our viewers are probably more familiar with, right? The NCAA is different than the NAIA.
Yes, the NCAA is different than the NAIA. The NCAA comprises mostly of larger state schools and larger institutions. The NAIA was put in place for all of those other institutions that couldn't compete at the same level as the big schools, as they like to say. Especially when it comes to the budget. So the NAIA was put together for those smaller schools, and it's turned into a real, really, really good run organization. And then the smaller conferences that have come from that, and it's given a lot of more kids opportunities who didn't get those big scholarships to go to the big NCAA schools. They now also have an opportunity to live the dream and to play college athletics. So Walla Walla, we are excited to be a part of that, and our goal, one of our goals, is to make it to nationals and be invited to a national tournament at the NAIA. They do the same format as the NCAA. It's just not on the larger scale with all of the different endorsements that come with the NCAA. But it's a great place to play. It's competitive, and they're about education and they're about grades. They are very intentional in making sure that student athletes have good grades at the college level and participate in sports. We're dealing with that right now with eligibility, trying to get our teams eligible. Right now in the fall, we have cross country, men's soccer, and women's volleyball. And coming in July, not realizing like it's a lot to get the eligibility together for these student athletes, but we're working hard at it. We took a break though to do this show with you though.
Well, thank you for doing that.
Thanks.
Now, you mentioned grades. I know that one of the criticisms that's often leveled, at least at NCAA schools, is that they're really slack, that they're letting the athletes get by or cheat or just kind of slide through because they really don't want a degree, they just want to get a pro offer.
Mm-hmm.
How does the NAIA stress academic achievement?
Well, I think the first thing, the difference being that most of the student athletes, and I haven't done an official survey, but just the eyeball test lets me know that most of the student athletes at the NAIA level, they aren't going pro. Okay, so that changes the dynamics on what their focus is also. At the NCAA level, you're getting a lot of the elite big-time prospects that are looking to go pro, and they're using this as a stepping stone just to get to the next level. But at the NAIA level, the mindset is a little different. A lot of our students come in knowing that they're going to go professional in something else besides sports. And so they come in with the mindset that they need to have good grades, and the NAIA actually rewards the athletic programs for those students having higher grades, unlike an NCAA policy where it's just different.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there's a stronger focus on academics in the NAIA than perhaps in some. And not to be critical of, the NCAA programs, because there are a lot of good ones where grades are stressed and people are trying to reach high academic standards. But that's one of the focus points.
And I think it's easier because the student athletes at the NAIA level know that that is probably more their career path than a student. I mean, I'm 6'9", and I play point guard, I'm going to North Carolina. I'm probably going to the league next year. So I'm not as concerned about grades as the 5'11 kid that's playing at Walla Walla, who athletically you probably aren't going to do that. And so you are a little bit more focused on your grades. And the NAIA picked up on that, and they did a good job of maximizing that.
Great. Mm-hmm. Now, Logan, tell me a little bit more about the athletes that you will be working with. Tell me, who they are, where they come from. We're located in the Northwest. Is that the only place where you get athletes, or is there a broader?
So one of my job duties is to enter all the rosters in. And being my first year here, I still don't know quite all the student athletes yet, but I've seen some of our students come from Oregon, Idaho, Washington, California. So it's kind of all over here in the Northwest here.
Okay.
And I'll be working with them. I'll be the game day manager. So I'll be interacting with them a lot on game days.
Very good. So as we look ahead to the entire year, what are the athletics or the sports that the university is involved with from fall to spring?
Okay, so I mentioned the three in the fall, which is girls volleyball, women's volleyball, men's soccer, and men's and women's cross country. In the fall, we'll have men's and women's basketball. And then going on into
the spring.
Spring, we will have softball at the
Club level.
At the club level. Mm-hmm. And then what is our last?
We also have men's and women's golf.
Men's and women's golf.
Okay.
Yeah, that'll be in the spring.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we want to focus on what's happening this fall. You mentioned volleyball, soccer, and cross country. Mm-hmm. So we'll take a closer look at those. So don't go away. Go away. We will be right back. Hello and welcome back to Valley Viewpoint. If you are just joining us, my guests today are Logan Adams, the Sports Information Director for Walla Walla University, and Eric Cantrell, the Athletic Director for the University. We've been talking about the program, and gentlemen, as we continue, I understand that the University has a plan, a program, for expanding the athletic footprint at the university. So why don't you share a little bit about what's happening there?
Okay. When I interviewed for the position, I got to sit down with the president of the university, Dr. John McVeigh, and he outlined that they have already approved and voted on and approved a plan over the next 5 years to grow the athletic department at Walla Walla University, and that they're charging the task to me and Logan to help lead that charge. We're talking about expansion of funds, scholarship money to roll over every year to come in, about $60,000 every year for the next 5 years for more scholarships. We're going to be adding full-time coaches to our staff in several of our sports, and those full-time coaches will also serve to help out in our administrative process in the athletic department, and also will be used by our PE department, who is headed by Rod Strobel, to teach one of our athletic classes. So in the next few months, those job opportunities and those job descriptions will be hitting the job boards, and we'll be looking for very qualified people to fill those positions and help grow our department. Also, we look at over the next few years to be expanding the number of student athletes that we have. And also, we will be looking to expand the number of sports that we have. Hopefully, with all this expansion, we'll be looking at getting some new facilities for the athletic department in the future. But at the moment, though, this is a really good plan that they've put together, and they've tasked us with being the ones to lay down the foundation and put the work in to actually help it grow, and using our expertise to help, you know, just mold it as it's growing. We will be the first in Adventist institutions to do a lot of the things that are outlined in the plan, and we want to make sure that they're done right. And that leads back to the vision that we were talking about for our athletic department and our student athletes at Walla Walla University to be the front runner in Adventist athletics going into the future.
Sounds exciting.
It's exciting, and it's hard work at the same time. So we're ready.
You mentioned new facilities, expanding to other sports, which also suggests more facilities to complement whatever sports those might be.
Mm-hmm.
So if we have a viewer that is interested in that vision and wants to support that, how can they do so? If they have, you know, some money that they would like to invest.
Well, the first thing I would say is that they would need to contact Jody Wagner. Jody Wagner is the Vice President for Advancement here at Walla Walla University, and she would be the person that could guide that process. Us being new, we definitely don't want to take on more than we can because we don't know all of the different ins and outs of it. But when working with Jody Wagner, briefly, we know that that is the person to contact when it comes to that, and she's a part of the administrative team.
Now, if you're going to expand the sports, that means you're going to have more people.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's a person that's interested in any of the sports programs that you've already mentioned, or wants to inquire about what may be rolling out in the future, how do those students get on board? How do they get to Walla Walla and participate in the sport of their choice? What are the steps?
Well, there's a shift happening, and I'll briefly talk about that shift. I think gone are the days where it's kind of a volunteer for sport. As we hire more full-time employees, for example, we hire a full-time coach, his job will be to go out and recruit athletes that he wants with his team and with his program. So I don't know if you are a student athlete at the high school level and you want the coach to notice you, I would suggest that you put together some film and find our coach's information on our website at uwolves.com and send that information over to the coach so that they know who you are and that they know if they give an opportunity to see if you are able to play at the collegiate level. Like I mentioned before, we've joined the Cascade Collegiate Conference, and it is a tough conference from top to bottom. So we are looking more for student athletes who can compete with those at that level, because that's what will make us successful as a department. For those who don't, though, we have a really, really, really intriguing intramural program happening in our athletic department that's headed by our Paul Starkeybaum. He's our intramural director. And we are also looking at revamping intramurals on campus for those students who aren't a part of the varsity teams, because we want all the students on our campus to feel like the athletic department belongs to them and that they have a piece of the athletic department and that they are able to show that their skills and explore competition and have the fun that competition brings even at an intramurals level. And so Logan will be marketing that just like we do all the rest of our sports. I think we have the app on our Go Wolves app that we are using to communicate to our students. And if you don't like sports or if you like sports but you don't like to play, we also have something for you. We have a booster club for Wolves Athletics that you can join. And if you reach out to myself or Logan, we can point you in the right direction on how to join that booster club. And you can still support athletics even without actually getting out there and getting sweaty. So.
Well, let me ask you a big question. Walla Walla University has its foundations in the context of a Christian university. So does physical education, physical development and excellence have anything to do with that broader context of being a Christian university, or is it just incidental?
When you say does it have any, does physical education and Christianity have
any connection?
Any connection? I think so. I believe that with Christianity and even with Seventh-day Adventists, with our health message, we should have some of the finest athletes out there, physically strong, mentally sharp, able to compete, and still be Christians. I remember when I coached high school basketball for the last 10 years, the years that we were really good, I would tell my guys, hey, we play the game hard during the game, and we shake hands after. That's when we become, you know, we go back to our Christian things. But during the game, we play hard, and we compete at a very high level. And I don't think that there is a problem with doing those as long as it's done like everything else that we talk about with moderation and temperance on how we perform and how we act. You can always still be Christian. I mean, that's just our mode. Athletics is our vehicle for our Christianity between us and others. Sports brings people together in ways that other things can't. And once you get them together, then you have an opportunity to show your Christian side to those people. At least that's my philosophy on it.
Okay.
You know, it's...
So there is a connection between the two.
Yes.
There is a connection between this is a Christian university and physical education is just a natural part of that.
Yeah, it is. And I think that we teach that in all of our different areas. This is where you actually get a chance to show that. We talk about health messages. We have one of the finest gyms on our camp on that I've seen in Adventist schools here in the States. We have a really good gym. They've built a new section of it where you can do stability balls and strength testing and all types of different things. And so we believe in it, obviously. Our PE department, like I said, headed by Rod Strobel, is really active. So we believe in it. This is just an opportunity. Athletics is an opportunity then to take what we believe and then actually show it out on the court with others. And then that gives us the opportunity to be Christians.
Now, you've led into the next question I wanted to ask, and that's about the facilities at the university. So you've mentioned the gymnasium. Tell us about the athletic complex.
The athletic complex is a shared complex that we share with the physical education department. We do have the gymnasium. We have our softball field where our women's softball team is. We've just expanded our soccer field to make sure it's NAIA regulation. We also have we use an off-site for our golf at the local, I think it's the Walla Walla.
Wine Valley.
The new golf course.
Yeah, the Wine Valley. So we're at the new one. So yeah, we have pretty good facilities. Like I said, we share those facilities with the PE department, but they really take care of us. We're set up for a scrimmage tomorrow. The PE department, led by Mike, came and set it all up and with Logan, and we're ready to go. It looked nice in there. We've got our sponsorships up. The floor was redone this year, and so it looks ready. It looks really good, and so we're expanding. We're still small though, but like I said, we're growing and we're expanding, and I think that as we grow and have success, our facilities and stuff, we're gonna look to upgrade those. But the WEC complex is a really nice complex, I would say.
For sure.
I was pleasantly surprised when I came out here on my visit and thought that it was really nice.
And I understand that you have a pool as well that might be available for some training.
Yes, so we do have a swimming pool that's open to the community. We have a rock climbing wall in there that's open to the community. Those things are run through the PE department, though, and not the athletic department. But if you go to see the PE department, they can give you access to that for a fee, of course. But they do run programs through there that the community and our students and our Walla Walla family are able to use.
Now, just in quick review for those potential athletes or sponsors, to get more information, go to
uwolves.com.
Thank you very much for joining us, gentlemen.
And thank you for joining us
on Valley Viewpoint today. If you have an idea or a suggestion for a future viewpoint, please contact me. You can call the station at 509-529-9149 or simply contact me at bmt.tv. For Viewpoint, I'm Dan Solis.